it's fascinating to me. So you've got all this acclaim, you don't want to live in LA, and you're coming back here, and now, like, what is the thing that's gnawing at your consciousness that wants to get out next? You've done Poor Superman, you've had a play done in New York, and you're back here, and you're like, what's going on in your creativity?
Well, I started working on Outrageous in that same period, and in fact, when
what inspired
we went to,
it?
Sorry?
What inspired it?
The movie Outrageous.
Okay.
Do you know the movie Outrageous?
It's
1977, directed by Richard Benner, written based on Margaret Gibson's short stories, the collection Butterfly Ward. Mm-hmm. And starring Craig Russell, who was probably one of the greatest female impersonators of all time. And Hollis McLaren plays his schizophrenic friend who lives with him. And it's an exploration of their insanity and their friendship. And I just have loved the movie, still love the movie. In fact, I showed the movie to like a 24-year-old drag queen friend of mine 2 weeks ago and ended up weeping through most of it while he watched it, just because of the memories and the emotions it evoked in me. And I always wanted to make it as a musical. So as soon as I had some clout, I called my agent, he got me the rights, and I started working on it. I started working on it with two composers in Edmonton, and we did a fringe presentation of the first act. But the music wasn't going where it needed to go, and I gave them a year to work on it, and they had done nothing. So I said thank you, and started working with another composer here. You know, developing a musical is like making a movie. Like, it is a long, drawn out process, and we must have done 4 or 5 major workshops at Canadian Stage over a 3 or 4 year period before we got it up on the stage. And it was the most difficult thing in my life that I've ever done.
Why do you say that?
Well, because it's not, again, it's so much collaboration. It's not just me writing, you know, when I write a play, I write what I want, I listen to what people say, I still write what I want. Mm-hmm. You're writing a musical, you've got to listen to the composer, you've got to listen to the producers, you've got to listen to what the people who maybe want to see the show are looking for. You know, what is the ending going to be? I mean, we had like 4 or 5 different endings that we tried before we finally got it up at Canadian Stage in 2000, I think we did it. And even then, we didn't have the time or the resources to do it properly. We had 3 weeks of rehearsal, and then we were in previews, and I had to fly to England to open Snake and Fridge. Mm-hmm. And so I had to leave that with my assistant, which was not the ideal thing to do. So again, like Wolf Boy, it's one of those shows that never really came to its proper conclusion. It never really had that development and that production where we all come together on it and realize what we're doing, and that is mostly, I realize, my fault, but it just never happened.